G'day, welcome to Baha'i On Air. We return again to our marvellous musical tour, Strings of the Heart, the travelogue of a musical journey by three musicians, Stefon, Pat and Paul. That's me. On this show, part two, the final part, you will see our Kiwi jokers continuing to use our music to bring the Baha'i message of peace, unity and love to our fellow country folks around the North Island of our beautiful nation, New Zealand. So, come and join us on our Strings of the Heart journey, where, through our harmony, our laughter and stories, you may learn a little more about something dear to our hearts, the Baha'i faith.
It's a really wonderful experience to be able to not only give, but what we get back in return is a wonderful feeling of brotherhood, if you like, and joy to be together and be able to share the talent that we have with communities and anybody who we come along with in contact along the way. The music, the effect that it has on them is quite startling sometimes. It softens that austere almost sometimes approach they have. They sit there with a grim face and start singing a song in the heart, and you can see, almost see them melt.
Oh, what a wonder is justice again. Surely it's the day of God.
Especially some of the kids' songs, and the way the children react to some of the kids' songs, that has quite a profound effect on individuals that are there amongst that atmosphere.
You might not know, goes we in the garden, raking the leaves, collecting all the honey from the buzzy bees, doing the dishes, feeding the fishes. We're all helping people in this special kind of life. Service, service with a smile. Don't go being like a crocodile.
Two Americans have written this wonderful, wonderful book called The Virtues Guide, and basically what it is. It's 52 virtues, like love and compassion, mercy, assertiveness, and obedience, and all these virtues that in some ways have been, I wouldn't say lost, but they've certainly been pushed to one side to a certain extent in this day and age. What we're endeavouring to do is to bring these virtues back into the lives, especially young children, so that the virtues become almost second nature in their lives, and the way they interact towards each other in a healthy way, respect each other, they're polite, they're kind to each other, they care about each other. And so what I've done is put a lot of these virtues into song.
Weeding the garden, raking the leaves, collecting all the honey from the busy, not yet kibbutz. Doing this in the fishes. Oh, helping people in a special kind of way. Sing it.
Service, service with a smile. Don't go being like a crocodile. Service, working every day. We're all helping people in a special kind of way.
Cause there's a fire putting out the flames.
There's our teacher.
He knows all the names. There's a dog.
doctor with a stethoscope, writing out prescriptions on a little white note.
Now, what seems to be the problem, young man?
He's a sick boy.
Serve us with a smile. Don't go being like a crocodile. Serve us, working every day.
Good feeling. A lot of laughter, a lot of fun and joy, and I think that's what really this tour is about. So we're on the road again, we're on the way to Napier.
Gonna pick me up a paper. Remember something new. Gonna pick me up a paper. Gonna read me the something new. Cause if you be that woman, I'll be the one you do.
Yeah, here we go now.
Oh, will that circle be unbroken?
Richard Cook, very young Richard Cook. He got a lot of hair there and a moustache. I mean, that's Barry Crump.
30-year-old Barry.
Shirley Charters. Bryce Peterson. So when was that taken?
74.
The year I became a Baha'i. Bitter, I hate
don't record this.
A friend of mine who, probably the last person on God's earth that I ever thought would get religion, my mate Bryson, he came sort of raving to me about this man, Baha'u'llah, and God, and all this stuff, and I thought, crikey, what's going on here? And then after about a year, I suddenly had this flight back from Dunedin. I'd been doing a show down in Dunedin. I was coming back in a 737. It was about 30,000 feet. And it suddenly struck me that I actually believed in Baha'u'llah, that I wanted to become a Baha'i. And now, I'm still very curious about the Baha'i faith. There are things that will take me all my life to try to fathom out in this religion. It's just so deep. So beautiful, so I can't find the words to express it.
O peoples of the earth, God, the eternal truth is my witness, that streams of fresh and soft flowing waters have gushed from the rocks through the sweetness of the words uttered by O Lord, the unconstrained. Still ye slumber.
And it seems to me the thing that makes most sense is this feeling of oneness, this sense of unity, the putting aside of the differences, of being able to forgive each other, being able to get rid of anger, to stop the conflict, to some of the things that are forbidden to Baha'is is something like backbiting. Something as simple as not backbiting about each other is a wonderful freedom. And those things I find really, really attractive. Criticism is a violation of human dignity and stuff like that, you know. So.
Cast away that which ye possess, and on the wings of detachment soar beyond all created things. Thus biddeth you, Lord of creation, the movement of whose pen hath revolutionized the soul of mankind. Of mankind. Of mankind.
There's a song, a lovely song that was originally recorded by a heavy metal group, and I don't know the name of the heavy metal group, but they were very noisy. And they sang this song called One God. And the lyrics of that are very Baha'i, because Baha'is believe that there is only one God and that all religion derives its inspiration from that one source. So this song sort of sums up the oneness of God. Millions of stars placed in the sky by one God. Millions of men lift up their hearts to one God.
So many children calling to him by many a different name. One Father,
loving each the same. So many ways all of us pray to one God. So many paths winding their way to one
Have a look at this amazing dog, you know. It's the most amazing friendly creature you ever saw in your life. How could you not love a face like that?
Give it a kiss.
Jose. Jose with the squeaky shoes. Jose. Jose.
Who put that there? When driving, avoid roads with forks in them. In fact, avoid all roads with any cutlery on.
Jose. Jose. Jose got a real cute nose. Jose.
Within the Baha'i writings, Baha'u'llah, it's a prophet founder of the Baha'i faith, he talks about the importance of music to uplift the sad and desponding soul.
Put a smile upon your face.
Everybody sing.
Happy.
Happy.
Throw away that frown. Be happy.
Happy.
Don't walk around the room full of gloom and doom. You can change the world if you're happy.
Happy.
Smile upon your face. Be happy.
Happy.
Show them to the human race how to be happy.
Happy. Happy.
The world what in the eye is the blue. Goodbye. Put a smile upon your face. Be happy.
To music being like a, he likens it to a ladder ascending into the realms of spirituality. And for me, when I was looking into the Baha'i faith, this amount of credence, that's importance that's placed on music as a creative force, and indeed to almost prepare hearts for, if you like, spiritual knowledge, really excited me. So I thought, wow, I can be a musician, I can play my music, I can write stuff, and I don't really have to, I mean, it's like I can use this medium to, in a real positive way, and have a great effect on humanity.
Beautiful, Paul.
Took 6 packets of birdseed to get one. Tears to the eyes.
One of our great experiences was back in about 93, we got an invitation to go to South Africa and have a concert tour. So before we knew what had happened, we were on our way and we went there, and it was probably the greatest experience of my life to be in a completely different culture.
These young Baha'is, well-known popular music singers from New Zealand, are traveling through Siskai in the South African homelands, making new friends, enjoying the familial fellowship of the old and well-established Baha'i communities of the area, and sharing their enthusiasm for the Baha'i teachings with anyone who is interested.
be able to experience that African rhythms and the culture and the wonderful spirit that Africa has, and the way they express their belief in Baha'u'llah and the Baha'i faith. Absolutely amazing. It's so different to the Western concept, and we were just so taken up with it. And their dancing and their singing for Pat and I was just an experience that we'll never forget.
Every day out, do a school, do a community at night, go to public places on the radio, on television, just recording our music and sharing our love of humanity and people, you know, and bringing them together. We were introduced to a man called Tozi, who was a very strong Zulu Baha'i, a very respected man. And he had this song called Tenasi Ahamba, which everybody seemed to sing. Even though you don't speak the same language, because we recognize the unity and the diversity of humanity and the oneness of all mankind, then we have a common starting point to communicate. We all believe in the same God. We all have the same basic principles of life.
Don't take your love.
Whatever she is now.
She just released an amazing CD.
I know, we got it. Breaking up is hard to do.
They say that breaking up is hard to do. And music's always been in my life. It's like spiritual side of me that's always been there. And one of the things that I've always felt is that music is a gift that God gave me, and that I must share it with people. I must give it away freely. If I don't use it wisely and unselfishly, then perhaps that gift may not stay with me. So one of the things I do on a regular basis is every single month for the last 15 years, I have entertained at least two or three of the old folks' homes in our region. I go there and give them a program of about 40 to 45 minutes of old-time music hall, wartime songs that they know and love. And I do that voluntarily.
Give us your tired and weak, and we will make it strong. Give us a simple song, and we will sing along. We are the gold.
Started to set about disproving the existence of Baha'u'llah, or that Baha'u'llah was the return of Jesus Christ, because that's what I was told, that Baha'u'llah was the second coming, so to speak. I went out to disprove it, and the more I read, the more I realized that in fact he was exactly the same spirit that I've experienced in Christianity, and that I, instead of disproving it, I came to believe the fact that Baha'u'llah was in fact the return of the Christ spirit in this, for this day and age. So it was a natural progression for me to move from being a Christian to being a Baha'i.
We are the multitude. We have no shoes to wear. Only our Lord is love. Living in the promised land. Oh, living in the promised land.
So I realized that this unificating spirit, this oneness of mankind, this essential creative force that went right through it, was also, it's a spiritual force. And you can see that in this age, I can see that there was an awakening of the spirit. There was a realization that more to life than materialism or scientific or logical thought, there was a spiritual thought. And having been a musician, it all makes sense. It's like the penny drop. And the music to me is kind of like that communication of the soul. And I think that on that level, musicians have always had this ability to communicate on a spiritual level, because there is a spirit. You know, they talk about soul music, gospel, spiritual music. It's not an accident, it's a valued statement.
Who is that?
I think many of us who are musicians have certainly experienced that wonderful ecstatic feeling when music just hits the note and we all come into harmony and it all works. A large choir, a movement, the symphony orchestra, a quartet singing, a beautiful voice that just hits it. We recognize that. The soul is able to recognize that wonderful spiritual sound that we get and that uniqueness. There's no way you can measure it. There's no way you can define it. It's just there.
My mother was not impressed with the fact that my father had seen fit to feed the pig before taking me out to the house. Not even when he explained that they already had three bands and the pigs were starving. So to pay him back, she gave me the names of three English kings, Alfred, John and Charles. My dad looked down at me in her arms, gave a sigh and said, "Ah, that poor little bugger. He'll never learn to spell in half of them." His prophetic words haunt me still, for I am still a small slip of a man with a little to me name, a name I have shortened to plain John, for I could never spell the rest of it.
That's really nice. That's good stuff.
We're now going into the kiwi fruit capital of the world.
I always had it in my heart that I wanted to play music, and I've been blessed in a way that I've been able to use music to earn my living. And I know that a lot of people, they end up in their lives doing things they don't really want to do just to survive in a matter of, or making a lot of money, but they end up, but I'm the other way around. I'm able to play my music and make a living out of it. In the early days, I was involved in a lot of groups, quite successful groups. One in particular was a group called Ebony, which toured New Zealand a number of times with various well-known artists. And we had a New Zealand number one hit, which sold 48,000 copies in New Zealand here, which is a big seller for New Zealand. And earned us a gold disc. And the year after, our group called Ebony won the New Zealand Group of the Year Award for the Rata, which was known then as the Rata Award. So, and I was only a young chap in my early 20s then. I thought the world was... It was all mine. That whole world of rock music and pop music is quite shallow and quite false. It's not really what it appears to be. And I learned very quickly that with fads and things that come and go, music can come and go as well. So. I really was searching for something a little bit more substantial in my life. And it was actually really that process of seeing the corruption and everything that was involved in the music industry that really sent me looking for something more spiritual and something I could really hold on to and give me some meaning to my life. And I changed my whole style of writing and what I wanted to write about and let the rest of the stuff go. So, yeah, in a way, I guess it was something I had to go through to be able to get to where I am now.
Such a reverend, reverend, practicing reverend. Oh, oh, whose presence you stand before? Reverend, reverend,
try to be humble at the threshold of your Lord.
Stills and Crofts, the American duo, both Baha'is, they were really largely responsible initially for introducing me to the Baha'i faith and the Baha'i teaching. But when I came across their music, I was incredibly drawn towards the power and the potency of their lyrics. And on one of those albums, I think it's called Year of Sunday, there's a beautiful passage, it's about Go East of Ginger Trees or something, and then in the middle of that song, there's a really beautiful sort of chant or a voice that says, Bahá'u'lláh, in sort of three-part harmony. And of course, Bahá'u'lláh was the prophet founder of the Baha'i faith, and it's the first time I'd ever heard the name of the manifestation in that way. I had no idea what Bahá'u'lláh was or who he was or what it even was. But just to hear that, I remember the feeling at the time. I thought, there's something about these guys and this music that is really special, and I really want to find out more about it, you know.
You don't let it slip away. Be still.
Be still in the night.
Let's work together.
Get together. Get together. Get together.
Come together. We will stand.
Yeah.
Boy, girl, woman, or man.
Well, folks, it's been a great and a most enjoyable journey. We hope you learned a little bit about our beautiful religion, the Baha'i Faith. A special goodbye from Paul, Pat, Stefan, and the team at Baha'i On Air. If you want any information about the Baha'i Faith, please check out our website, www.baha'i.org.nz. We hope you'll tune in to our next episode of Baha'i On Air. I'm Paul Bennett. Kia ora, folks.
I like it.